Do you really need a switch for home network? Or is a router enough? Many people have this question when setting up or upgrading their home network. So how can you determine if you need a switch? First, let's understand the difference between a switch and a router. In a home network, a switch is mainly responsible for connecting multiple devices within the local network and providing data exchange. A router is used to connect different LAN or WAN, allowing them to communicate with each other. For example, if you want to connect two computers, you only need one cable. However, if you have 30 computers that need to communicate with each other, a single computer won't have enough ports. In this case, you would connect these 30 computers to a switch to enable communication. But if you only use a switch, like for playing games, you can only play offline games within the home network. To play online games, you need a router for internet access. Thus, it is clear that a home switch primarily serves as a port extender in a local network. A typical router usually has 4 to 5 ports for network connections. If you need to connect more devices than the router has ports for, you'll need to buy a switch to increase the number of ports. In a home setup, you typically connect the router to the internet first, and then connect the switch and devices to it for data exchange. So, how to choose a home switch? There are several factors to consider, including port number, switch type, network speed, PoE, and fans. Home switches typically come with 5, 8, 16, or 24 ports. The choice depends on the number of devices you plan to connect. We recommend choosing a switch with more ports than you currently need, allowing for future expansion. Next, based on your network needs, choose between a managed or unmanaged switch. Unmanaged switches are plug-and-play devices that require no configuration, making them suitable for simple needs like adding more network ports. Managed switches offer better network control, allowing you to manage, configure, and monitor network setting. And the speed of the switch should match your home bandwidth and the speed capabilities of your devices. For example, if you have gigabit bandwidth, you should choose a gigabit switch. We recommend selecting gigabit or higher network switches, such as 1G or 2.5G switches, to meet most home needs. Additionally, PoE functionality is important. If you have devices like IP cameras, VoIP phones, or Wi-Fi access points that need both data and power, you need to choose a PoE switch. Of course, when purchasing, don't forget to check the total power budget of the switch and whether it meets the power requirements of the device. Also, you need to plan the location for your switch to determine if you need a fan. If the placement is not soundproof and you care about noise, it is best to choose a fanless switch. If you want to place the switch in a confined space, such as a weak current cabinet, you also need to consider the size of the switch. Standard switches are usually 19 inches wide, and the height varies with 1U or 2U sizes being larger. For narrow spaces, it is recommended to choose a compact switch, which can be as small as half the size of an envelope, making it very suitable for home use. It offers a variety of home network switches. Consider the factors mentioned above and choose the switch that best fits your needs from our website. Thank you for watching, and if you liked the video, please like and subscribe to our channel.